Coming up next, Mr. Thom Richard in the P-40 Warhawk. Ladies and gentlemen, a World War II powered by an Allison engine. That was the first engine that was put in a P-51 Mustang that didn't meet the qualifications and the speed and the altitude that the British wanted when we built it for them. And Thom Richard, his own history is worth almost as much as watching the air show, because he came to the United States with $2,500 in his pocket. He arrived here, he was 17 years old. He was born and raised in Sweden. And he decided at the age of 7 that he wanted to fly warbirds and he wanted to race at Reno. And the only way to do that was to come to America. And so his dad gave him the $2,500. And off he went to pursue his little piece of American dream. And here he is today, living and flying that dream. Now, look at 350 miles an hour into the Barnstormers Loop comes Thom Richard in the P-40 Warhawk. Thom has accumulated over 14,000 hours in general aviation, which well over half of that is warbirds and a quarter of it in helicopters. Let's watch him fly while I tell you a little bit about the Curtiss P-40 Warhawk. Was the absolute backbone of the U.S. Army Air Corps up through 1943. It saw action in all theaters throughout every day of World War II. First test flown back in October of 1938. Over 13,700 of these aircraft were built. He owns Warbirds Adventures in South Carolina, where he and his crew would gladly teach you aerobatics. I'll tell you more about that a little bit later on. Thom appropriately named his airplane the American Dream. As you see, 1.5 rolls on the way up. The American Dream, after his life story. Like I said, he'll teach you all of the maneuvers that you see him performed a day in any of his aircraft. Look up warbirdadventures.com. You can visit the P-40 Warhawk American Dream on Facebook. And if you're already a pilot, you can get your P-40 type rating in this particular aircraft with Thom, because it's 2 control airplanes. Regular Cuban 8 maneuver now with a 2-point hesitation roll on the down line. Up over the top on the 45 down line, there's one. And rolls it to the upright, 2-point hesitation roll. Well done, Thom. He's well known for his air racing around the world, a World Cup winner in the International Formula One class. He's also raced various jets, and most famously, the Griffin-powered P-51 Mustang Precious Metal. Among others, Thom has been sponsored by Breitling Watches and is currently sponsored by leather jacket manufacturer Cockpit USA and the Allison V12 engine builder, Ace Allison's. 90-degree barrel roll into the wing over reversal. Big, giant barrel lying on its side out there, Thom, flying the P-40 Warhawk around the outside of that barrel. Thom just recently relocated his entire operation to the American Dream Sky Ranch up in South Carolina, beautiful private grass strip between Columbia, Greenville, and Augusta. You can enjoy going up. It's really a bed and breakfast coupled with aircraft training. All right, here we go. Thom in an 8-point hesitation roll. Counting out. The American Dream, one of 13,738 P-40s made. Probably remember the airplane from the Flying Tigers, and there's several television, movies made about the Flying Tigers, as well as TV shows. Thom in from the right once again. Got that throttle pushed all the way forward for the Allison. Brings the nose up. Aileron roll once. Aileron roll twice. Aileron roll three times. Precision of an aerobatic pilot. You can tell how good they are by just watching a maneuver like that. If you'll notice, Thom entered that maneuver at a certain altitude, did all of those maneuvers, which requires moving every control surface on the airplane, and exited that maneuver at the same altitude that he went in. And that what makes a excellent aerobatic pilot. Toughest one to do is a very, very slow roll, and it is meaningful in that the outside of the airplane is moving in all directions, as well as you moving the stick, ailerons, and rudder in all directions. Up over the top. 8-point hesitation roll. You cameraman, better get your cameras out. Now I want you to watch this next maneuver. It will be a topside, almost inverted parabolic straight pass for all you photographers out there. So crank out that long lens and get ready to start shooting as Thom Richard brings in the American Dream, the Curtis P-40 Warhawk, for this parabolic straight pass. Here we go. Looking right down inside the cockpit. Where did he go? Behind the trees. Right down on the deck, and then a hard pull to the 45 upline. Now watch him as he rolls the airplane to the right. Gonna finish up with a lot of fast aileron rolls. And he said he'd continue to do that till the air boss gets tired of it. I'd mention our air boss today is two of them, George Klein and Brad Klein from Charlotte, North Carolina. In from the left now, is skipping over the top of the trees is Mr. Thom Richard. The American Dream. Here's an interesting story. On his way down here, he had a cooler failure on the airplane, and the engine stopped. He was at 27,000 feet, and then just knowing Thom so well, set up his emergency procedures and dead sticked it into the nearest airport. What do we mean dead sticking? No power. Prop was stopped. Here we go once again, a final pass, I believe. Prop was stopped. Thom, being the aviator that he is, put it down beautifully at the nearest airport that he felt could handle his airplane.